If you were born between 1946 and 1964, you're one of more than 80 million Americans who can officially call themselves baby boomers. All this week, we're telling you stories that affect this generation. The oldest baby boomers turned 66 this year, and many are thinking about where and how to live the rest of their lives. There is one alternative, living in what is called co-housing, communities where families of all ages live in a development of a couple dozen or more homes, cooking and eating together a few times a month in a common house, tending a communal garden together, and making decisions for the common good of the group. There are about 120 of these communities across the country. Joining me is Jennifer Ryan. She is a member of the Temescal Creek co-housing in Oakland, California. Jennifer, very nice to see you. I understand you've been living with your partner Bill for about 20 years or so in this community. Tell us why you decided that you would live this alternative lifestyle.
Well, co-housing is kind of a laboratory. We're trying to find ways to live where we can support each other and nurture each other in our day-to-day lives at a time when most people in society don't have family and friends close by. In co-housing, we have a network of closely connected people right in our backyard. We share our daily lives. We help each other reach our dreams.
We're looking at some pictures that you sent, actually. It's really fascinating to see. I know you've got a community garden here. It looks like people are eating together. Explain to us, what are the benefits of this compared to, like, if you're living in a regular neighborhood, let's say, or even in a retirement community?
Yeah, well, in co-housing, one of the hallmarks of co-housing is that we share meals together. We take turns cooking. And in my community, for example, we have meals together twice a week. And for me, it's really a highlight of my week to get together with my neighbors, you know, to see what's going on, to chat and to share and catch up with the kids. In my community, we're a multi-generational community. And for me, that's great because I have an opportunity to interact with, you know, little kids, with teenagers, with the tweens, as well as with people in their 20s and 30s and 40s.
It sounds like a lot of fun. Now, I know you guys have some rules in the group here, and you call them work parties. So how does that work, actually? Do people really have to follow the rules? Who makes the rules? How do you do that?
Well, we have work parties. In my community, we have them once a month, and we're mostly working on the outdoor areas in the gardens. We do a lot of food raising, especially in the last couple of years, and we actually have summer gardens and winter gardens. One of the things I just love about my community and working in the gardens is it's really terrific to see the fruits of our labor, literally. You know, we're sharing that with each other instead of, you know, if I were living in a in my own home,
sure,
just by myself, I wouldn't have that fun of sharing with other people.
And Jennifer, is there a moment where if you decide, you know, I'm not really up for this anymore, you can simply move? You don't have to, like, stay and be a part of that community all the time?
Well, of course you don't have to stay. A few people leave co-housing because it doesn't work for them, but most people stay. It's actually a very much lower turnover in co-housing communities than in the rest of the country.
Tell us what the highlight is. Any interesting, funny stories that have happened that don't usually, you know, that's kind of unique in your situation? I see people are
sure,
all in the trees together.
Yeah, well, the one in the trees, we had to take down our oak tree because it was dead. And everyone was very sad about that. So that was sort of the last day of the oak tree. You know, another sort of multi-generational tale, a good opportunity, is that on election night, we gathered to watch the returns. And one of my young neighbors, Miles, came around and was trying to understand the Electoral College. And so I sat with him for a while and showed him an app where you could move the bubbles around with the different electoral votes. You know, and he was just enthralled. I wouldn't have that kind of opportunity if I just lived on my own.
Sure. Well, Jennifer, it sounds like a really nice community, and it certainly works for you and your family. So we wish you the very best. Thank you for coming on. We appreciate it.